Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video I want to demonstrate a few keyboard shortcuts you can use to quickly add up a column of numbers in Excel. I'm guilty of putting this in a portion of an Excel assignment before. I know other teachers have done it, where we give you a spreadsheet of different size columns and your goal is to sum them all up. And the reason we do the different size columns is just to make it a little bit harder so that you just can't copy one formula and paste it over multiple times. However, if you know a few Excel keyboard shortcuts, it's still a pretty easy exercise. So first, here's what we're trying to avoid. We don't want to just, you know, activate the cell at the bottom of the column of numbers, and of course equals sum, and get that range. Closing parentheses, we get the sum there. I'm going to Control Z to undo. Now you could be thinking, oh, hey, just use that auto sum button. And sure, we can activate the empty cell beneath the column, click the auto sum button over in the right side of the home ribbon, and it looks like it's putting the function there for us. Press enter. Cool, that works too. Even a little bit faster, right? There's another way, still using the mouse though. I select all of those numbers in the column. Notice I'm also selecting the empty one at the bottom there. Then I can click the auto sum button over there on the right side of the home ribbon, and it just pops the total in. That's pretty fast. And of course I could select auto sum, select, notice I'm getting that empty one at the bottom, auto sum, and there you go. So it's pretty quick. And if you're handy on the mouse, then it won't take you long at all. I'm going to Control Z to undo. But this video is about keyboard shortcuts. So here's something we can do. If I activate the cell beneath this bottom here, I can press Alt equals on my keyboard. That enters a sum function for me. Enter. That cell right at the bottom, Alt equals, enters the sum function for me, and enter. So I can use Alt equals to quickly enter a sum function of the numbers just above it. I'm going to Control Z a couple times to undo that. I still had to reach over to my mouse though. So here's another technique. I'm just clicking on A1, which is the top of my first column there, and I'm going to press Ctrl Shift Down Arrow. That selects everything in that particular column of numbers, and then of course Alt equals puts that number right down there at the bottom. And then I can right arrow selects that next number, and then it's Ctrl Shift Down Arrow, Alt equals, Control Shift Down Arrow, Alt equals, and you can use this combination to quickly select. If your hands are already on the keyboard, it's really not too bad. Control Shift Down Arrow, Alt equals to get that sum. So it's not that one of these ways is better than the other, and when it comes down to it, once you get good, they're all going to be pretty darn quick. The key is if you ever catch yourself that doing something in Excel that seems a little bit slow and a little bit inefficient, you always need to ask yourself, is there a better way? One more thing we often ask you to do on these two is go ahead and format these. And let's go ahead and look at one other quick trick. So I'm going to select one of these sums, and I will make the background color yellow, and I'm going to make the text color blue, and I'm going to do a comma style with no decimals. There we go. Once you've got that formatting that you like, double click the Format Painter button. 1, 2, double click it, and then you can just click on the various results. Once you're done formatting those other cells, click the Format Painter once to turn off that Format Painter feature. Thanks for hanging out with me.